Giro dell'Emilia 2021. They're just coming up to the San Luca climb, which is like 2K at 10%. We've got Adam Yates, Jao Almeida, Remco Evenepoel, Mike Woods and Primoz Roglic. We've also got Remco Evenepoel's power data, which is good to see. It's on the power is on the left-hand side, then gradient, and then we got speed and cadence on the right-hand side. It sort of is really fast run into the bottom of the climb, and then it gets steeper and steeper towards the top, and then a little flat, and then more steep. But Remco is basically just doing a lead out for Joao Almeida here, and he's just saying, boys, I'm going to set a very hard tempo. He starts off really hard, 450, 460 watts. I think for the whole climb, he averaged 400, but you'll see that obviously he blew up. He's going way over his limit for this sort of effort. But yeah, it's good to see Remco being a top quality teammate to Joao Almeida after the Giro d'Italia, where people had a lot of, you know, theories that he wouldn't work for someone else. Adam Yates is looking not bad. Jersey unzipped. Mike Woods again. This is quite a classic finish for both Mike Woods and Primoz Roglic. You know, a really hard VO2 effort followed by a big sprint at the top. Roglic has won this race a fair few times in the past, and yes, it is good to see the power data. You really get to see how fast these guys climb, especially with the power, with just the speed. Remco, I think, probably is 63 kilos ish 64 kilos at the moment, so the numbers are maybe not as crazy as it seems on Strava if you just trust his watts per kilo. And Mike Woods, I think, is also, you know, around that sort of similar weight. Obviously a taller rider, a lankier rider than Remco Evenepoel is, but you can also see Remco's cadence is very high as well. Often sort of always over 90, which is impressive on a climb like this. We can see Vingegaard is behind. Power's dropped down a lot compared to like when he first got on the climb. He really was stringing out a lot at the beginning of the climb in comparison to now, where Vingegaard is just looking a bit rough. Remco's looking around now. I guess he's wondering, like, you know, what does he actually need to do in order to help Joao Almeida win this bike race? Well, Roglic knows what he has to do. He knows he is the best sprinter. He just has to hold on to the back. Mike Woods and Adam Yates, again, they've probably got to go from further out. I think Joao Almeida also has to go from further out, because in a 20-second sprint, Primoz Roglic is just one of the best in the world, and it's very hard for them, anyone really, to beat him. I don't know, you know, maybe Alaphilippe, maybe Pogacar in a flat sprint could have a chance, but when it's uphill like this, after such a hard effort, it really is very, very tough to beat him, really, in any sort of circumstance. Obviously, there was even the time trial up here in the Giro d'Italia in 2019, which I believe he won as well, with Yates coming second. But we're going to switch over to Mike Woods' power data now, because the attacks are coming. Joao Almeida just has decided it's time to go. Remco has sacked it off. And we're with Mike Woods' power data, so it's in green, just so you know. We'll flick around a little bit. But you can see here, we're up to 530 watts. The attacks are going. It's 20% gradient. It's 12K an hour. This is a proper climb. Roglic is grinding. Roglic just loves this. He's got a blue tire on the front of his wheel. They sort of look around a lot here. Yates does this weird thing often where he goes really low cadence and just sort of like grinding, just looking like he's, you know, a bit tough. But you can see the watts here aren't absolutely bonkers. It was really, you know, big, big acceleration early. But then I think Yates again decides that, you know, if we ride at 370 watts to the finish, Roglic is going to be pretty fresh and is going to batter us all in a sprint. So we need to make sure it's hard. You can see the power numbers going up to 500 watts now for Woods. And this is the thing with the climb, is it's unbelievable. Woods is on the front now, drilling it, trying to drop people. It's just unbelievable because they're so good at attacking and then recovering. And recovering at, like, you know, a high percentage of their threshold. Obviously, the absolute numbers are ridiculous, but it's still a very high percentage of their threshold. You know, we're probably talking 90% of here of his threshold, and he's still going to be able to recover and put in another attack. Remco's riding it smart behind. He knows, obviously, he's just got to ride at probably basically 400 watts, I think it was, to get back on. Now, Yates goes on the attack again. You can see the numbers getting back up to 600 watts again in order to follow him. And Yates looked really good. This is what Yates had to do. He had to make it really hard. Joao Almeida, the tongue is out. He's ready to give it the big beans. And Mike Woods on the back here is probably enjoying the 20K an hour draft that he's getting up this 12% climb. I mean, it's decent, but it's nothing. It's nothing crazy. It's just mano a mano who's the strongest in reality. And they're about to go through sort of a right-hand then left-hand turn. And this is where it does start to flatten out a little bit. They go through the arch here. And, you know, when I say flatten out, it's still 10%, but the speed comes up a little bit. They ease off the gas, you know, 100, 200 watts. At this moment in time, you might even be able to keep up with them. But they're just waiting. And I think this is for two reasons. Number one, you bring Remco back into it. And number one, Remco. Number two is because Primoz Roglic has become more and more fresh. But at the same time, you know, it's hard. What do you do? Because if you just attack the whole time, you know you're going to get battered in the sprint. So, you know, it's one of those things where you just got to attack and hope for the best. Now, with Remco's power data, you can see Remco's coming back now. Remco's going to attack straight through, hits 800 watts, goes flying past. Look at the speed difference here. Mike Woods decides it's time to hop back on. But Roglic says no. Cheerio. Ciao, Almeida. Now we go on to Mike Woods' power data. Look how many watts Mike Woods is doing. And Roglic is absolutely flying away from him. He's doing 800 watts here. And look how fast Primoz Roglic is going. This is absolutely bonkers. Like, you think he's doing like 1,100, 1,900 watts at the moment compared to Mike Woods. Like, this is, you know, crazy, crazy anaerobic ability by Roglic. I don't think I've ever seen anything like it really from anyone. Even Valverde, like, he was really punchy. But just that sprint, like 20 seconds of just pure and utter power. And he put in such a big gap on like not even the steepest part of the climb. You see what I mean? Like, look at the speed. He's like freewheeling there. Woods is still doing well over 400 watts and is getting nowhere near him. But anyway, a stunning performance by Roglic. Cheers for watching. Hope you did enjoy this video. And we'll see you in the next one.